Sorry, hi guys. How are you guys doing? Right now I'm not gonna do a reaction video right now. I'm just gonna talk about the situation in Thailand where 13 persons are missing, and that's 12 students and a coach. They're missing in a cave in Thailand, and I just want to encourage. This video will be more of a video of encouragement to you, the followers and subscribers of Juno Suggest Documentary who are from Thailand, and those who are also hoping and praying on behalf of the people of Thailand, like myself, living in another country. I can well imagine that this is a very difficult situation right now. They have been missing almost for a whole week now. I cannot start to imagine what they're experiencing in that cave. I believe that they are alive, but they are patiently waiting. They are waiting for the rescuers. They are waiting for that sound of hope. They are waiting for that light of hope. And I just want to encourage the people out from Thailand. I know that you guys are strong people. I know that you guys are people of hope. I know that you guys are persons who have faith. You were once led by a great man, that's King Rama the Ninth. And I surely believe that he have taught you guys well. He have set examples, and he have sort of passed on his wisdom to those who are in authority and the people of Thailand. He is a man of faith, and he's a man who do not give up. Clearly, King Rama the Ninth is a king who never gave up on his people. And I want you guys to know that even in reacting to all the videos out from Thailand, learning about the culture, the people, the food, the different things about Thailand, I've come to a conclusion that love is something that is great in Thailand. Hope is something that is great in Thailand. You guys believe, okay? You guys believe and have hope. And that is something I think that keeps us going as human beings. Sometimes everything is against us. Hunger is against us. The cool air is against us. The sun is against us. And what keeps us going is love and hope. And I believe that is what is keeping the 12 students and the coach in the cave. They have hope, and they know that there is love. They know that the people out from in Thailand is really pressing to save them. They know that the Navy, the Army, they are pressing. They know that the divers, they know that the King himself must be putting so many resources forward to ensure that they are saved. The government also in Thailand, I know for sure that they know that there are persons who are hoping that they are going to be saved. One of the persons, or one of the group I think we should really try to encourage the most is their parents. Because imagine you are a parent and you know your child is hungry, you know your child is cold. I don't think as a parent you will can eat, you will can sleep. I just cannot start to imagine what the parents are feeling like. So I think while it is that we have to have hope for them who are in the cave and that they'll be saved, we have to encourage their parents, their family members, their friends to keep hope alive. Don't give up. Believe that they will be found. Trust that they will be found. And of course, pray, pray, pray. Because it's a very difficult situation. I understood that they were the rescuers, the divers, they were trying to find them, and then the rain started falling again, and that sort of hindered and delayed the rescue. But they're back at it again, putting the resources forward to ensure that they save them. And we have to hope and pray. At the end of this video, I will personally pray. For those of you who don't know, I believe in God Almighty. I believe in Jesus Christ. And although I've been reacting to videos about religion, of the different religion in Thailand, even Buddhism and the monk and so on, I still don't. My idea is not to judge and to cast anyone aside and to say that what you believe in is not the truth. If that's what you believe in, that's what you believe in. And somehow we all believe in something. I believe in God Almighty, and I believe in Jesus Christ, and I believe that if it is that we as Christians, I'm a Christian, if it is that Christians ask for something in the name of Jesus and have faith, I believe that God can perform it. For those of you who have your different way of praying or who you believe in, continue to do this for the people of Thailand and continue to encourage their family. Of course, one of the things also I would like to encourage you guys is to learn from this. It's not just about saying what could have been done. They are in the cave right now. This entire situation is a way to learn. The great king of Thailand, King Rama the Ninth, did not just come up with solutions. He observed the problem and then he learned from it and he created solution. This is an opportunity to learn solution, to make better the rescue team, to make better the divers, to make better the students, to encourage them, even those who will learn from this will learn what not to do and what to do, what to hold with them in case of a situation like this. And I think all in all, we should try our best to pull positive from this situation. Positive from this situation. We should try our best to just know that there is a lesson to be learned from this, and they will be rescued and they will have a good testimony. They will have something to share with us. And I cannot wait to see them on you guys making requests for me to see that video when they are rescued, to see that moment when they speak to the interviewers, to see that moment when they hug their parents, to see that moment when their parents' heart is given peace to know that they are in their arms well and able to talk, to sing, to laugh, to cry, to grab, to hold. That is the hope that I have, and that is the hope I want you guys to have, okay? All of you who are out there, if it is that you guys really believe, it only takes 3 or 2 to believe in something, okay? 3 or 2. And all of you guys who are subscribed to Jesus with Just Coming True Believe, and all of you guys pray, and all of you guys say something positive in reference to finding the 12 students and the coach, it can happen. This is what propels us. This is what causes us to grow and to develop and to move on, is knowing that there is love and there is hope. Take, for example, Jesus with Just Commentary. It's you guys showing love and hope that keeps pushing me and me, keep pushing me to keep producing, keep creating, keep reacting, because you guys are showing love. And this is what keeps us going as human beings. This is love. Of all the videos I've reacted to so many videos of love. And this is an opportunity. This is an opportunity where we can actually have faith and we can believe that they will be found. This is our moment to believe. This is our moment to believe. I have people like Body Slam who showed love, ran from one part of Thailand to the next to show love for total strangers, to push so that persons would donate. Total strangers would donate. This is love. King Muhammad IX did so many things for his people out of love and hope that his people will know and learn and push. And I believe that the king have taught us something. He have taught something which would be the solution to finding these 13 persons who are missing in the cave. So I want you guys to believe and trust, okay? Do not lose hope, and I know that they will be found. They will be hungry, they will be cold, but they will be found alive, and they will have a testimony. Of course, I'm going to now give a prayer. Those of you who believe in Jesus Christ and those of you who believe in God Almighty, you could pray along with me. No matter who you believe in, actually, Allah, Buddhism, monk, whatever it is that you are believing in, I want you to just say something of hope, prayer of hope. I'm going to pray right now for those of you who believe in Jesus Christ. Of course, pray along with me. And please be encouraged by this prayer, okay? Almighty God, I come before you this evening and to thank you for your mercy and your grace. And to thank you for your compassion that you have allowed such a peaceful moment, such a moment that I can come before you. Father in heaven, I come before you not in myself, not to show that I am good enough to even come before you, but through your Son, Jesus Christ. Believing, Almighty God, that your Son, Jesus Christ, is who you see in me. Father in heaven, this is a very difficult situation. You know all things. You know everything even before we think of it. You know a situation before it even happens, and so forth. Lord God, you know the solution to everything. Father in heaven, there are 13 persons. 13 persons in a cave. They are cold, they are hungry, and you know, Almighty God, where they are. You know, Almighty God, when they will be found, and you know, Almighty God, exactly what direction the divers, the rescuers would have to go to find them. Father in heaven, I ask for favor upon the rescuers and the divers in terms of the weather and the rain. I pray, Almighty God, that you give them favor, that it will be a good condition that they can continue the rescue. Father in heaven, I pray that you comfort the hearts of the parents, the friends, the students, Almighty God. Father in heaven, I pray that you comfort them, those who are out there waiting patiently, the communities, the families, the schools. Father in heaven, I pray that you comfort them. You give them strength, Almighty God, to know that there is hope. Father in heaven, you are the greatest, Almighty God, and you have shown us hope. You have sent your Son, Jesus Christ, and to give us hope, Almighty God, at this moment that I can't even come before you, Almighty God. Father in heaven, I pray, Almighty God, that you favor them, Almighty Father. Thank you for the wisdom and knowledge, Almighty God, that you have given the rescuers, the divers, the inventors, to create devices, to create things, Almighty God, in situations like this, that it can be used for your glory and your honor. Father in heaven, may you continue to spread wisdom and knowledge to all men, Almighty God. May the talent of man, Almighty God, exceed, Almighty God, in such a way that it could help other human beings. Father in heaven, may it be used for good. Almighty God, at the end of this situation, at the end of this, Almighty God, may you be glorified. Father in heaven, I believe, Almighty God, that these students and the teacher or the coach, they will be found and they will have a testimony. This will somehow comfort the heart of someone who is broken, someone who was at the brink of giving up upon life itself. May this situation even comfort them and strengthen them to know they are in good standing. It might have someone out there who was about to give up on this life, upon this world, and they saw the tears of her parents, they saw the tears of her community, and they've gotten hope, Almighty God, from this situation, knowing that there is love. Father in heaven, I pray that you continue to guide the leaders of the nation of Thailand. I pray, Almighty God, that you give them the discernment to make wise decision for the betterment of the people of Thailand. Thank you, Almighty God, for this opportunity, Almighty God, that you have somehow exposed me to Thailand for this very situation, that I can pray on their behalf. Father in heaven, I did not know that this situation would come, and no one knew, but it is what it is right now. And it is in your word, Almighty God, and it's written in your will, and I believe in your will it is that they will be found. Father, all glory and honor be given unto you, Almighty God. All glory and honor be given unto your Son, Jesus Christ, for the miracles that you are about to perform. Father in heaven, may you be exceedingly and exalted, glory above all, Almighty Father. Thanks and praise for all that you have done and all that you're going to do in the precious blood of your Son, Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Of course, guys, don't forget to share these videos with your families, your friends, to encourage them. Of course, for those of you who have sent me messages in reference to what's going on, thank you also in the group chat, that's Juno Sweet Just Commentary, the group chat, also in the Facebook group, Juno Sweet Fan Club. Of course, continue to send messages, let me know what's going on, leave a comment, leave a post on the group, let us know what's going on. Thank you so very much. Lagon.